morning. Welcome back to Breakfast Television. And he's a musician, entrepreneur, fashion icon, and Oscar-winning actor, Jared Leto. One of those rare actor-singer success stories out of Hollywood. With his career spanning two decades, he's continued to be creative, take risks, and innovate. I got a chance to sit down and talk to him, Dina, and whew, this guy is... He's grown. Very interesting.
Yeah.
Because he is very knowledgeable. Excuse me, he's very hardworking as well.
Also, he has grown so much as an actor, and he is so great as a musician and an actor. And by the way, he's turning 50 in December.
Yeah.
The guy does not look like a day over 35.
Excuse me. Yeah, December 26th is his 50th birthday. We addressed that in this conversation. So he's part of the Audi Innovation Series. You remember last year? It's the fifth anniversary. Last year, we spoke to Masai Ujiri.
That's right.
About this, right? When he's down in Florida and they're getting ready to go into the bubble. So this year, it's Jared Leto as the featured guest. It's a conference about digital innovation, creativity, risk-taking, just innovating in general. And he does that quite a bit. So we had that conversation about it. We talk about... You know, him being a heartthrob back in the day.
Yeah, still.
Do you remember that? My So-Called Life, 1994 with Claire Danes.
I never watched it, but everybody loved that show.
I know Mel's probably, like, cheering over there. Huge fan.
She cannot wait.
Huge fan. Yeah.
I'm sorry. He was, like, my first real crush, Jordan Catalano.
Go.
Loved him.
Mel,
he was so mysterious. Yeah.
You are as excited about seeing Jared Red as if he's, like, he's going to appear live
I'm
as
pumped.
I am about Angelina Jolie later.
There it is.
Yeah. Let's be clear.
Yes.
30 Seconds of Mars, of course, rock band, right? That band sold over 1.5 million album, or 15 million albums, sorry. He's gotten Oscar awards, Dallas Buyers Club, Girl Interrupted, Suicide Squad, The Little Things, so much going on for Jared Leto. And then it's the fashion on top of that. He's a fashion icon. So let's get right to the conversation because he does give me some tips, which I know y'all are waiting to check out.
Okay.
Here's the convo with Jared Leto.
We got the awards with acting. You got tens of millions of records sold. You've got your hands in a lot of things when it comes to being an entrepreneur. We're talking about the innovation series here with Audi. What does that word or what's it mean to innovate in your world with all of those things and the many things that you work hard at?
Well, to innovate means to break rules and to push yourself to do something that hasn't necessarily been done in that way before. You know, whether it's business, creativity, music, art, fashion, whatever.
You mentioned fashion in there, and there's many days where I look and I'm like, would Jared approve? You know,
No, you look good, man. Yeah.
Thank you.
I side noted when I came on, I said, you know, he's got it going on.
I appreciate that. I really do. Where do you get that creativity from?
My secret to fashion is, you know, you might have to beep this out, but I really just don't give a f-. That's really my secret. I don't take it that serious. I don't put that much time into it. And I'm okay having fun with it. I'm okay making mistakes. But you could try a little handkerchief.
I've got, because I do the hair bands. We're going to get to hair in a quick second.
Okay.
So I could maybe just do this.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah?
Yeah, there you go.
All right. You've had the locks for so many years and they look great. Quarantine and COVID has done this to people. And, and there is moments where I say, what would Jared do with this hair? What would you do with this?
Mohawk, for sure.
Yeah.
There's only one way to go, bro.
Do you have a favorite side?
Yeah, it's the back of my head.
Because I'm looking at Instagram, and it's a lot of times it's the left. I don't know if you've noticed.
But it depends what side you're on in the camera, you know?
That's smart.
But I'll give you the right now.
I like it. I know you're not afraid.
Sometimes I save that for, you know, family. But
age is just a number, but that number is 50 this year. Do you take the time with all the accomplishments to stop and think about what you've done, or are you always trucking forward to seeing what's next?
Yeah, I don't really sit around. It's great to have done some of these climbs, but you're kind of looking at the new one. You know, I was talking with Denzel, and he was talking about Academy Awards, and when you show up on set, that award doesn't help you in that scene. You know, it's like showing up to your next fight. That belt, it's not going to win the fight for you.
Dean, look at that, eh? Getting advice from Jared Leto.
I need all the help I can get, so I appreciate that, Jared. Thank you so much. And the one thing, he's a huge fan of Denzel Washington.
Okay.
That's what I've learned throughout the last couple of weeks about him. So doing the little things was a thrill for him to work with Denzel, and they've become good friends from that.
You never think about that. Like, when they're A-listers, who were they watching growing up with, and now they're in the same film together? That's why. That's surreal, right?
One thing, and I asked him, you know, about, you know, what is he best at? Is it the music? Is it the acting? Is it the entrepreneurial skills that he has? Because he's had his hands in a lot of businesses. He said, I'm good at working hard, which I can respect and appreciate. And we've seen that. It's paid off for him with the band, with 30 Seconds to Mars, of course, and with all his acting skills.
Totally.
And then where he's at as an entrepreneur. So shouts to him for innovating, and thank you for everybody for setting that up.
That was great, Dee.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun talking to him.
That being said, was the student teaching the teacher? Guys, who looked better, Devo or Jared Leto?
No, don't do that. Don't do that.
Whose outfit did you like better, guys?
Devo. Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Coming up next, we want you guys to sound off about Devo versus Jared Leto's outfits.
No. That's...
It's not about that today.
But the U.S.
We're actually talking about the U.S. Is it a glimmer of hope, Dee? You heard the news.
Yeah.
They're talking about going maskless because so many people have received a full vaccination, both doses.
And they're saying indoors and outdoors. So does that give you hope for our future? 1-866-267-3797. Feedback at breakfasttelevision.ca and at Breakfast TV gives me hope.
Same.
Yeah.
They're opening up Disneyland, restaurants, cities are bustling.
Yeah. Vegas clubs are banging
right now. Let us know, everybody.
Yeah.
We'll be back with more BT right after this. Have your say either way.
Yeah, thank you.